What's up, guys? Pastor Rob here, back with another reaction video. As usual, I've got my son Gage.
What's up?
And as usual, we're going to be reacting to a song requested by you guys in the comment section of our videos. This song, Gage, has been requested for years.
Yeah, for sure. Ever since we started the channel.
And I've avoided it because I have an idea of what it's about.
Oh, yeah. People have explained it in the comments.
But I think it's timely. I think it's time. I think it's time to check the song out, give it a good listen, see if we can get through it. Hopefully, we'll have a really good, productive conversation after the song. But it's the song by Korn called "Daddy." So yeah, I don't know what else to say other than I've been dreading this for some time, and if it's not good, we will not upload it. I don't mean the song, but I mean if it doesn't translate into a good discussion or anything like that, we won't be, you know. If you're seeing it, then this is pointless, but you get the idea.
Yeah, fair enough.
All right. Ready to get into it?
Yeah.
Just jump in? Okay. Oh, you know it's going to be bad when there's a warning in front of a Korn video.
Disclaimer.
Hopefully there's music. I have never heard this in my life.
Is that Jonathan? I've never heard him sing like that.
Yeah. I just had to get out all my pain and suffering. Quite emotional, actually.
Yeah.
Bass,
yeah, good bass, classic.
What's that noise?
Little child, looking so pretty, come out and play. I'll be your daddy, innocent child.
I'm not sure how much I could take.
Yeah, it's pretty rough. You got an extra lyric sheet?
I know, it's
just one.
Just one.
Dang.
Well, let's just keep it going, I guess. It's very weird because you want to, like, of course the beat's good.
Yeah, that guitar is sick.
It is.
A pinch harmonic.
As a child, I doubt that's
That was very intense.
Yes, it was. So when I heard the concept of the song, you know, obviously I thought it was going to be just filth, just for the sake of filth. You know what I mean? Just
like, yeah, kind of like that Infant Annihilator song.
Yeah. Did. Exactly. Soil the Stillborn, I think it was.
Yeah.
wow. I was definitely wrong. That was well done. I mean, if you can say that about a song like this.
Yeah.
But it was...
I don't think I've ever heard someone put emotions like that into a song like this.
No, and this is obviously somebody who's experienced this in a real way. I mean, what do you say?
Yeah.
You know, what do you say? There's nothing I'm going to say in this video that's going to comfort anybody who's been through that. I mean, there are some things I can say to help. But, you know, it's obviously a song about somebody who was molested by their parent.
Yeah.
Their parent, their mm-hmm. dad, particularly in this case.
Yeah.
Or stepfather, I don't know. It's weird because like he's appealing, he's confused by what's happening. Like, why are you doing this to me? You know?
Yeah.
And even though you think you're doing this in secret, God saw you.
Yeah.
This is my God saw you. Or actually.
No, I think that's more of a curse to God. Like, my God saw you watching.
You think so?
Why didn't you do anything? That's what I feel like.
Okay. So I scream, no one hears me. So I'm hurt, I'm not a liar. So he's told somebody who is not believing him.
Yeah.
Maybe even somebody who he thinks should know. Maybe my God saw you watch. Like, I think you're right. I think he's saying, I don't know. Whew, that's a heavy, heavy thing. Mommy, why your own child? letting this happen and then feeling dirty. Mommy said she didn't care. So again, mom did nothing. Yeah, I screamed, no one hears me. I'm hurt. I'm not a liar. No one believed him. I mean, that's the thing about this, is this is somebody being molested who's telling, who's trying to get help, and nobody's hearing.
Yeah.
And then at the end, I believe that probably is real audio from the studio of him.
For sure. If I recall correctly, I believe I saw someone explaining that he broke down at some point during recording the song. And I believe all that was left in there.
I mean, it makes sense. It's just...
It really sounds like it.
I mean, obviously he wrote the song, so he's probably dealing with it while he was writing it. Just getting it out there and writing it from the perspective of when he was a kid.
Yeah.
And then just at the end of the song, after getting the lyrics out, and we talked about repetition in the last song. There's a lot of repetition in here.
I was thinking that, yeah.
Yeah, he's just emphasizing this pain. I mean, what else do you need to say?
Yeah.
But he says it multiple times because it needs to be said multiple times so you can get the feeling.
Well, yeah, like I said in the last the Linkin Park video we just did, repetition in music always drives home your point.
Mm-hmm. The same in the Bible, actually. Whenever something's repeated.
That is true.
Yep. But he has that breakdown at the end, which was so emotional. Now, you could hear this and be like, it's filthy. Well, yes, it's a filthy topic. That is true. It's a disgusting topic and awful. And somebody may say, well, why write a song about that? Well, if you've experienced it, maybe this is one of the ways you can cope by writing about it and sharing your experience with others and allowing others to receive a little bit of... little, I don't want to use the word comfort, but just knowing somebody else, especially somebody they may admire, like the singer, went through this, can identify with it.
Yeah.
Right? And then at the end, he's breaking down crying. I'm like, you know, I'm not a big cussy guy or cursing or anything. Like, I don't curse. And, you know, I think taming your tongue is a wise thing to do and a biblical thing to do. But how... I mean, when you break down to that level, how else do you express that level of anger and pain and hate?
Yeah.
Righteous indignation. I'm going to use that word. He's rightfully angry.
Yeah, for sure.
Then the song ends with what sounds like a lullaby. Maybe that's supposed to be like it's from his mom trying to comfort him, or maybe that's the comfort he was hoping to get.
Yeah, that part was crazy.
I don't know, but it just made it even more haunting because it was almost as if the mother didn't care still. I don't know. Like, maybe she didn't care and was just trying to comfort him with the song rather than do something about it.
Yeah.
I have no idea, but that was haunting. Heart-wrenchingly graphic and descriptive, and it captures that raw anger and emotion from a victim in a terrible situation. I was having trouble getting through the song because I wanted to stop it and hug the kid. Like, there's no kid to hug.
Yeah.
But like, I knew kids when I was young who were abused. I've counseled people who have been abused in different ways, and I know what it's done to them in their whole lives. Sometimes it's generational. Sometimes abuse people. And you just want to reach out, and you wish you could just pull them out of that situation and undo what was done, you know. And you get angry for them. You want to go yell these same words at their, you know, the person that did it to them.
Yeah.
Like I said, there is nothing. First of all, I'm sorry for anybody who's gone through something like this. It affects you for your whole life, and it makes sense that it does. So don't feel wrong for hurting, because this is a hurtful thing. Imagine the situation: the person that you are supposed to love, trust, and take care of you and protect you from evil does the most vile and evil thing to you.
Yeah,
that ruins all of your future relationships, ruins your future love life, your marriages, your dating. You're gonna ruin your kids, maybe. I mean, don't get me wrong, there's people that survive this. I don't want to.
Yeah, for sure.
Yeah, I don't want to speak hopelessly here, but in a lot of cases, people struggle for a long period of time with these things.
Yeah,
and there's nothing I'm going to say here that's going to fix it. It could take years of counseling. Sometimes God can remove that from somebody and they can use it for a greater good in some way or the other. But I can tell you this, I can share some thoughts, okay? We know from Scripture that man's depraved. We know that. So that's the evidence. This kind of thing happening is the evidence of the depravity of man, that man is inherently sinful. And sin exists in this world. We've gotten numb to some sin. We're okay with it. We watch it on TV and in our favorite movies and all this other stuff. But there's other sins that hit us right between the eyes. This.
Yeah.
And this is sexual immorality. This is harming a child, child abuse, all these things. And God hates those things. And when he said, "My God saw you watching," God was watching. And the Bible is pretty clear about the extreme value of children. It's pro the blessing. A child is a blessing and anti-abuse for sure. Just read Leviticus 18, 6 through 18. It's a long list of things you shouldn't do as far as abuse and sexual abuse goes. Mm. And Jesus even says in Matthew 18, "Whoever causes one of these little ones who believe in me to sin, it would be better for him to have a great millstone fastened around his neck and to be drowned in the depth of the sea."
Mm.
Think about that. I wish I could go to his abuser and tie a millstone around his neck. The Old Testament, in fact, has stoning for such things like this.
Yeah.
Now, I think we should bring that back. Yeah. I think for this particular crime in particular, stone, millstone. Stone them. When they stone them, you know, they depends on the type of stoning, but sometimes they bury them neck deep and just throw rocks at their head until you die. Could you imagine that?
A lot of these people get imprisoned and they don't make it too far after that.
I was a chaplain in the jail system. I know when somebody came in who had charges similar to this, if that got out, they had to be moved. And they go to a different pod until it got out. And they go to a different pod. And sometimes, you know, if they did somebody wrong, they'd make sure it got out there. And people would hurt them.
Yeah.
And rightfully so. Again, if they're guilty, sometimes those guys are in there and they're not guilty. I mean, probably few, but still, there are some. So you have to be careful on how they go. Some have those charges, but I don't want to get into that, but there's some gray area there. Maybe they were 18 and their girlfriend was 17. Their parents pressured, that kind of thing. You know, that's a lot different than this. I mean, they shouldn't be doing any of that stuff until they're married, but you get the idea. So again, a millstone. Now, you know what a millstone is?
I mean, it's like a big stone used in a mill for like...
Millstone? Yeah, got it. That's pretty sharp.
Yeah. I don't know.
Way to divide that word. Yes, used to, you know, crush grain and turn it into flour and things. It's a big old heavy rock.
Yeah.
Like, you ain't swimming with that joker.
No way.
You'd be like swimming with the fishes, like getting cement shoes like the gangsters used to do. Like you're sinking down head first to that bottom and you're just going to drown. What a terrible way to die. And that's true. And then, of course, there's hell. Hell. Think about what Romans 12 says. "Beloved, never avenge yourselves, but leave it to the wrath of God, for it is written, 'Vengeance is mine, I will repay,' says the Lord." Now, you, in the song, "My God Saw You Watch," the assumption, maybe, if we're interpreting it correctly, is that God didn't do anything.
Yeah.
Maybe not in the moment. I don't claim to understand why God allows these things to happen. That's the hardest thing to discuss for any theologian, theodicy. Why is evil happen? No matter how you look at this, this was evil, terrible thing. I don't know why God does it, but I do know, and why he allows it, and why he doesn't just throw lightning down in the moment.
Yeah.
I don't know. Maybe. I don't know. But I do know he promises vengeance, and that vengeance may not be till judgment day. That vengeance may be a guilty conscience for the rest of their life that they have to wrestle miserably with, or the fear of being caught for the rest of their, whatever it is. God's doing something maybe you're not seeing, and in the grand scheme of things, God will have his vengeance. He will repay. Leave it to the wrath of God. Wrath's a word we don't use a lot. That is unmitigated, unrestrained anger, righteous indignation, anger rightfully from the God of heaven and the creator of the universe. Mm-mm-mm. So trust that God will deal with it. And remember that the Lord is near the brokenhearted, Psalm 34:18. The Lord is near the brokenhearted, and he saves the crushed in spirit. You're a victim. That's what you are. God's near you. You may feel dirty, like in the song, but Jesus washes us clean. You're not dirty. You're not dirty. That person was dirty. What they did to you was dirty and filthy and unforgivable, to my opinion. But you're not. You can be washed clean by the blood of Jesus by faith. Become new. You're born again. You're a new person, a new creation. All the old things are gone, and the new has come. Trust Jesus. Find peace there. Find peace. He'll be near your broken heart. He will help heal you. He will renew you. You may deal with the ramifications of this for the rest of your life, to some degree or the other. But you can find comfort in God. You can. There's no way without. I don't know how you do it without God. I don't know. I don't know what philosophy or what practice some psychiatrist can give you. I don't know, journaling. I just don't imagine that.
Yeah.
You know, and those things probably help too, but ultimately, for sure, trust in Jesus and trust that there will be vengeance on Judgment Day. Trust that. I don't know what else to say. This is not an easy topic to discuss in this format, but I love you. That's all. I don't know. If nobody's told you that, I do. And if you're somebody who's been hurt and feeling love, I love you. I don't know. I mean, sincerely, like, I wish I could hug you. Wish I could comfort you. I wish you didn't have to experience that. If I was there, I would have done something. I would have helped you. I promise that. Somebody would have got hurt. I can throw some bows now. I'd have been crushing some skulls. But of course, scripture says leave the vengeance to God. But I would have had a little trouble with that one. Yeah. God forgive me. I would have been in there and rear naked choke and just choke him out, you know? I would have been there for you. Not to make light of the situation, but
yeah,
just know you're loved. Jesus loves you, and I love you. Gage loves you, I'm sure.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know. If there's anything we can do, just send us a message, Facebook, Instagram. Seems silly to self-promote at this part of the video, but
yeah, but I mean, the purpose is for you to have someone to connect with.
Yeah, we're here. I mean, you know, there's so much you can do online, but
yeah,
it's an option. And if not, we can help you find the help that you need. I can help you find a qualified counselor in your area, things like that.
Yeah.
If you made it this far, thank you for watching. And all right, well, I don't know. Till next video, may the light of the Lord continue to shine on you, and may he be near your broken heart.
Mm.
Peace.
Peace.